today I've got a Christmas look for you, or at least some kind of holiday look, but it's inspired by the colors of Christmas, so, you know, to me it is pretty much green and gold and red. Also inspired by these earrings that I bought ages ago with Claire's. But anyway, it's the sort of Christmas look that I would do myself, so it's like, it looks fancy, glittery, special, but it doesn't take a lot of time. Which to me is quite important, because I don't want to spend ages on my makeup on Christmas morning. So yeah, let's get started.
I'm going to start out with priming our face, and sorry if I sound like I have a cold, that's because I've got a cold. Logic. But yeah, the primer I'm using is the silicone primer by The Ordinary. It really seems to fill up my pores, which is very, very nice. It makes them look all smooth and, you know, barely there. Then, for my eyes, I'm actually going to start out with my eyes again today. I'm going to start out with priming them with the concealer and powder that I'm actually going to use on my face later as well, because obviously I had it lying around anyway. The concealer is by Catrice. This is our liquid concealer. I'll just put the names and color codes and everything of everything I've used below in the description box as always. Just easier than trying to remember it all. But I'm applying that on top of the eyelids, all the way from the lashes to the eyebrow, and then also a little bit underneath my eyes. And then I'm just powdering it with a powder puff and my Catrice powder. And because of powder puff, like, it applies enough powder that everything is thoroughly set, but to make sure that there's not too much powder there, I am going over it with a tiny little, tiny little powder brush, I think it's supposed to be, by Real Techniques. And then I'm moving on to the actual colored eye base. This one is 24K Gold from Maybelline Color Tattoo. And I'm just applying it with a flat synthetic brush. I think this one is by Body Shop, but I'm not sure. It's really, really old, but any synthetic brush will do. And I'm just applying it all over my eyelid and also in the crease. And also a little bit underneath the eye, just to, you know, make sure that all the colors are going to be on top of it later are sort of going to be tied together. Then for the eyeshadows, I'm using the Androgyny Palette by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. Really, really nice colors. I really do feel like this palette is very, very suitable for winter and autumn for some reason. I know it wasn't originally meant for it, but I don't know. It just really gives me an autumn and winter feel. But either way, I'm starting out with sort of a warm taupe nude-ish shade. Well, you can see what it looks like. Just a nice transition shade in this case. And then I'm going to use Military, which is sort of an olive green. And I'm just going to pat that not all across the moving part of the eyelid. I'm mainly focusing it on the outer third. I'm trying to keep the inner parts golden because I want to highlight them later. And yeah, darkening them up first would not be very useful for that. I do find that patting it on works better than rubbing it on over top of this particular color tattoo, because the color tattoo is, well, it's rather glittery and not very, it's sort of opaque, but as you can see, it's not one even layer of color. So if I swipe other colors on top of it, they just don't seem to grab on all that well. But yeah, once the olive green is on there, I'm using an angled brush and sort of a darker green in the crease and the outer V. And this one actually stays green on the eye. As you can see, it doesn't go gray, which is very, very nice. A lot of green eyeshadows do actually have the tendency. Then, first off, to blend that, I use the sort of warm taupe-ish nude shade again on a blender, a smaller blender. And then I'm using a clean, large blender just to blend everything out. And then I'm moving on to red. To me, red and green and gold are just really the ultimate Christmas color. So I wanted to incorporate red in this look as well. Obviously, it's going to be in the glitter, but I also wanted it to be somewhere else. So I'm adding it underneath the eye and sort of in a wing. For that, I'm using a tiny pencil brush and I'm also blending it into the crease area, as you can see there. And just the gold just ties everything together, I think, like the gold base underneath. And I wanted to have the inner corner even more golden, so I'm using pretty much an old-fashioned eyeshadow applier to eyeshadow applicator, yep, to apply it in the inner corner to highlight it. And that's pretty much all the eyeshadow work we're going to have to do. And it's time for liner. And the liner, I'm going to keep the black liner very, very simple. The only reason I'm applying it really is to give the eye a little bit more definition. And also because I'm planning on wearing falsies. And the falsies I'm planning on wearing have a black lash band, so yeah, it's just nicer to have something there already so they don't show too much, like the lash band doesn't show too much. I'm using this Line Refine by, I think it was L'Oreal or Maybelline. I'll put it in the description box. And yeah, I just made a very thin line, and then I'm moving on to glitter. I'm going to use the Glitter Primer by NYX for this, and then some loose glitter. To be safe, use eye safe glitter. But what I'm doing essentially is just pretty much doing a winged liner in bits. Because if you will do the entire liner in the primer first, I really don't think that the primer is still going to be sticky once you get to the end. Because obviously it does dry. So yeah, I'm just doing little bits and pieces and I'm not dragging it all the way through to the inner corner. I'm mainly keeping it where the green also is. Just seemed more, I don't know, it seemed to work better. And I'm also applying a little bit of it at the outer corners on the bottom eyelid, mainly between the lashes. But of course, I am trying to not put it too close to my eye. And alternatively, by the way, you could do the black liner after the glitter. However, I do recommend doing it first because trying to make a non-crooked line over top of glitter is very, very difficult. Because glitter, of course, has some texture to it. So yeah, that's why I did the black liner first. Then I'm using the Vertige mascara by Yves Rocher on my lashes. Lots of it on my bottom lashes, and on my top lashes I'm mainly just focusing on getting the base of them black. And then it's time for falsies. The falsies are by Kiko, the glue is by Peggy Sage. And yeah, these are actually, again, I'll just put the name of them below in the description box. I think they were called Sophisticated. Either way, they're really, really pretty, and they're actually surprisingly comfortable. Very thin lash band, and the inner corner is really almost natural, and then the outer part, as you can see, just wings out really nicely, and also it has little tiny black gemstones on the top. So it just looks very, very nice when looking down. As you can see, it's quite a distinct difference. And it is time for some eye pencil. I'm using a black eye pencil. This one is by Estee Lauder, just to make sure that there's no skin showing through on the top. And also, again, I just really like defined eyes, so I really like making my entire waterline black. And also the inner corner. And also that outer corner. For some reason, on that outer corner, it seems to fade earlier with me, even though this particular one doesn't fade at all. In the outer corner, with me, it sort of seems to fade, even though it never does in the inner corner. But yeah, then it's time for my face, and yes, I finally bought a beauty blender. I know I'm horribly late with it. I know everyone already has a beauty blender. Probably everyone already is on their, like, 10th beauty blender, and I'm here using my very first beauty blender. But yeah, a little while back, as everyone probably knows, there were Black Friday sales, and then Cheapskate Me finally found it the right time to finally buy a beauty blender. I did actually try cheap beauty blenders in the past, but you know, 99 dollar cents one, which is in euro cents even less, of eBay, you know, you can't expect a lot of them, and you shouldn't because they suck. I also tried one by a better brand, however, that one was like, it was like a soggy brick. It was ridiculously hard. Just really hard to use. But the beauty blender is really, really soft and bouncy and just very, very nice. And yeah, now that I know that there's actually such a thing as a useful beauty blender, I do actually want to buy more of them. And also still try different brands. But yeah, for now I just have this one that's actually, you know, an official beauty blender. And it just works so quickly. And yes, I know I look ghostly in winter. Also, I'm really back with using my Catrice powder for some reason. I haven't used it in ages. I still love my Peggy Sage powder a lot. But this one just gives a tiny bit more coverage. Even though it's also called translucent, but there is some color to it. And it does actually keep my makeup in place really well. It looks really natural, so I've really fallen back in love with it. Then for my brows, I'm using the Rimmel Brow This Way. And as always, just, you know, I think I always say this. Just do your brows however you feel they look right, because your brows are pretty important, like they're quite a central part of the face. So yeah, I just fill mine in as always, using a nail art brush. And what I always like to do when I do a more dark look, I do try to keep my eyebrows a little bit darker as well, just to make sure that they don't sort of, yeah, go forgotten amongst the eyeshadow, I guess. And then it's time for contouring. I'm using this Métier palette, which I dropped a brush from, but anyway. And I'm just using the dark shade over here in winter. In summer, I actually used the pale shades as well to counter contour, but that's not very useful in winter because then I'm a ghost. So yeah, I'm keeping it at the contour shades. And as you can see, it's, well, it can be pigmented if you use a lot, but it's very easy to build up. So, you know, it's very, yeah, safe to use, I suppose. Like, you won't get a random brown smudge very quickly. If For that I use a fan brush and then I'm using the red shade from the eyeshadow palette on a stippling brush as a blush. Wasn't sure how it was going to turn out, but I actually really, really like it. And a stippling brush just applies it very naturally. Then for highlight, I'm using my Catrice highlighter on a tiny powder brush. And this is just a very nice, sparkly, very pale gold shade. It's golden sparkly enough to tie in with the eye look, but it's not too dark for my skin. And I'm also using it on a short shader. Just to highlight my brow bone, because for me, this eyeshadow palette doesn't really have many highlighting shades. Then for my lips, you could go for a classic red, you could go for a daring green, but I decided to keep it at nude this time. Because I don't really do that all that often, pale nudes don't look very good on me, in my opinion. So I'm using Maroon by Catrice, which as you can see is quite dark, but it's very, very nice, and I always tap it with my fingers afterwards, looks very charming, I know. But this just makes it last longer. And then here is the final result. I really enjoyed finally filming a holiday look again. I hope you're looking forward to more holiday looks, because I'm definitely going to do more of them. Yeah. And as always, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. For now, as always, thank you very much for watching. And see you next time. Bye!